My name is Terry Key. I'm a chemist. I'm in fact an inorganic chemist in the School of Chemistry at the University of Leeds. And today I'd like to tell you a little bit about electrochemistry. In the first session today, I'd like to introduce the topic of electrochemistry. What exactly is the subject of electrochemistry? Essentially, it's very simple. We're aware that there are around us a multitude of chemical reactions. Chemical reactions abound. But there are a group of chemical reactions which can be used to generate electricity. And also a group of reactions in which we can use electricity to drive those chemical reactions. Today I'm going to tell you a little bit about electrochemistry, and in particular the way in which chemical reactions can be used to generate electricity. Electrochemical reactions are not the easiest to understand, but they are quite common. They are, in fact, all around us. So one of the common examples of an electrochemical reaction is corrosion, the rusting of iron. The rusting of iron, essentially what happens when iron rusts is the metal is giving up electrons to oxygen in the air. This is a type of reaction that is very commonly harnessed in electrochemistry to create electricity. The process of rusting is an example of a redox reaction. The word redox is a combination of two different words, reduction and oxidation. Both of those processes involve the change or the exchange of electrons. Reduction is the addition of electrons, and oxidation is the removal of electrons. So when you have a chemical process such as the rusting of iron, the corrosion process of iron, what you have is an electron transfer from iron to oxygen, in this case, from a donor to an acceptor of those electrons. Iron corrosion and iron rusting is something that we're all fairly familiar with. Here, for example, I've got a key, one key of many on my particular key ring. This particular one is quite rusted around the edges. I touch it quite a lot. On my fingers, there is moisture, and in that moisture, there is salt. And salt is very important within the moisture for accelerating the rate of that corrosion.